guys, it's Chris, and today we are talking about the problem of resisting change. So many of us really are invested in particular outcomes, whether they be in our location, our career, our relationship. We are invested in having it be a certain way. We are invested in having it stay a certain way. We don't want it to change. And I can intimately relate with that. I used to be married to someone else. So I've talked a lot about my divorces and my mistakes and the things I've done in my life. And so I was married before. And when that marriage was kind of coming to an end and we were on the verge of, you know, losing our home and so many things were shifting, I was resisting that change. I was so resisting that change to the point that I became at times kind of hysterical about it. And I would be demanding spirit to make sure I could keep the things that I wanted to keep right in the place that I wanted them to be. I was demanding it and I was resisting any sort of change. But what happened ultimately? Change came. The change gonna come. It comes no matter what. The more we resist it, the more we make that a painful experience for ourselves. And sometimes change is just supposed to happen. It's karmic. It's a space or a place in our life that we are called to experience in order to learn a lesson in a challenging way. There's nothing wrong with that. We have to trust this process of life. We have to trust the process of listening to spirit. And if change is inevitable, we always know it. Resisting it is folly. It makes it harder for us. And so in the end for me, I lost that beautiful big house. And so in that end for me, I lost the place that I lived, the geography, and I lost that marriage. But that is what for me was meant to happen. No judgment around my marriage, please. No judgment around me or my choices. I don't judge anybody because I know how the landscape of life is always shifting because it's supposed to. This is an earth school where things change and we intentionally respond to that change in order to get to the next level, whatever that means for us. And for me, that meant that I left that geography, which was Chicago. I moved to Colorado and I kind of just went on an adventure. I gave it up, people. I just was like, fine, whatever, like let it all go. I surrender and I'm going to go on an adventure. And spirit, you lead me to what is meant for me next. And I came here. I met a lot of really, truly beautiful people who were higher than my level and who allowed me to level up to their level. I learned, I grew. It was an exciting time. And ultimately, I met someone new and I have a different house. I have a different experience. And I must say that even though it was truly painful, and it was, no doubt about it, it was. I am so grateful that I had the fortitude to surrender. It takes strength to say, okay, God. It takes strength to let something that you love go, but it's the key to happiness because that's when spirit truly gets the space to lead our life in the direction that we ought to go. And when we're living a spirit-led life, we're always happy. Doesn't mean it's easy. Doesn't mean we're super healthy. Doesn't mean there's no challenges, but we're always, no matter what, happy. So trust life, trust spirit, trust the writing on the wall and what your gut says about that writing, and surrender to the wisdom of source energy, surrender to the flow of life, be on an adventure, be open to new possibilities, and I assure you, if you do that, you will end up in a very, very good place.